When it comes to time, science says we can't stop it, nor can we go back in time. Which got me wondering, is it possible to give the illusion of going backwards in time with science? And it turns out, there is. So grab your old retro toys, because today, we're going back in time. Welcome to Impossible Science. Hey everyone, it's Jason Latimer, world champion of magic, coming to you with another Impossible Science. Now, I'm going to show you how to take your old toys, the ones that have turned yellow over the years, and show you how you can rejuvenate them to make them look like they're brand new. Now, the secret ingredient today is
electromagnetic radiation.
Now, you're probably going, whoa, what a? Electromagnetic radiation. It's all around us, and yet it's a hidden world you can't even see. Like other waves, an electromagnetic wave transmits energy, but unlike other waves, an electromagnetic wave is capable of traveling even through the vacuum of outer space. They have crests and they have troughs, and the distance between these crests is what's called the wavelength. The number of crests that can travel through a given point in a single second is what's referred to as the frequency. A wavelength can be so long that it's measured in meters, but it can also be so short that we have to measure it in the billionths of a meter, called a nanometer. These varying wavelengths create what's called the electromagnetic spectrum. In this spectrum, we have long wavelengths with low frequency known as radio waves, followed by microwaves, then infrared waves, visible light, ultraviolet light, X-rays, and then gamma rays. Gamma rays are the shortest wavelength at the highest frequency, but there's no limit to how high they can be. Even though these wavelengths are all around us, our eyes can only detect a small region of this spectrum, 400 nanometers to 700 nanometers. It's this sliver of the electromagnetic spectrum that makes up all the various colors we can see. But anything outside that region, well, that's invisible to our eyes. Okay, now that we know the electromagnetic spectrum exists, you're probably wondering, what does that have to do with de-aging our toys? Now, anybody who's had a toy from like the early 80s, 90s, or 2000s, you're starting to notice that the plastic is degrading over time. For whatever reason, they're turning yellow. Now, you could try to clean the surface of this and use like regular hydrogen peroxide, and it may clean off the surface a bit.
But just cleaning it will not get rid of the yellowing in the plastic. Because plastic can be made of many different materials, it's hard to say exactly what makes plastics turn yellow over time.
But the real secret ingredient is UV light.
UV light happens to be the right wavelength to break up chemical bonds, which is why UV light damages so many things.
Let's clean up the surface, let's prep everything we need. I'll show you how to build the UV chamber, and let's get started.
Here's what you'll need. A waterproof box, some sort of lid or cover to that box, some tape, a UV light string with enough to be able to wrap the box several times, hydrogen peroxide, safety goggles, and rubber gloves. After you grab an adult and have your toy, it's time to take it apart. I'm using a Sony PlayStation 1, but you can use most any plastic toy that has turned yellow over time. First, remove the plastic cover. Then, remove the electrical components. Here's a pro tip. When I take something apart that's new to me, I always roughly draw it out on paper and tape each screw to the drawing as I take it apart. Then I know where all the pieces are supposed to go when I put it back together. Step 2. Build the UV chamber. Now, most of the UV light is going to be coming in from the top, but I'm going to wrap the entire box anyway. We'll wrap the outside with all the UV light strips, facing inward. Since the lights can't be submerged into the liquid, we need to put them on the outside of the box. But this means there's a lot of the UV light will be absorbed by the plastic container. This also means the majority of the UV light will be coming from the top down. Step 3, wash the plastic components. Now before dipping the surface into the hydrogen peroxide, we need to get rid of all the dirt and oils off the surface. Step 4, add the hydrogen peroxide. You'll need to use some gloves and goggles for this, and a hydrogen peroxide that is at least 3%, or your normal household peroxide. This is definitely something you want an adult to help you with. The stronger the hydrogen peroxide, the more careful you'll need to be, just to make sure that it doesn't touch your skin or get on your clothing. Step 5, submerge the plastics overnight. Now, I suggest keeping them in the hydrogen peroxide for a minimum of 24 hours. If your toys are really yellow though, you might want to keep them in for even longer or try a stronger hydrogen peroxide. Now we need the UV light to turn the hydrogen peroxide into that super oxidizer. So I'm going to hit the PS1 from all sides. Now the majority of the UV light will be coming from the top because it doesn't have to pass through the plastic. So I suggest stirring the hydrogen peroxide every once in a while throughout the entire experiment. Make sure to always wear gloves and don't get any in your skin. Step 6, rinse the pieces off. After 24 hours, rinse all the plastic pieces with water to get rid of any hydrogen peroxide that's left over. Step 7, reassemble. This is where you might want to look at your drawing to be reminded about what screws went where. Depending on how yellow your toy was, it should be as good as new. And you can actually do this process again if you want to see even better results, or the next time your toy starts to age again.
And there you have it, seemingly new PlayStation 1. If you enjoy just taking an impossible topic and making it reality through science, let me know. Click the like button, share the video with your friends, and if you want to continue to find out more goofy things that you can do to make an impossible topic a reality, make sure you subscribe to the channel. And until next time, stay curious. Because the right question changes everything.
I'm gonna play some games now.
Thank you for watching. Impossible Science!